Vice President Mike Pence with an explanation that doesn't add up as to why he didn't wear a mask when visiting coronavirus patients at the Mayo Clinic. You can see the vice president here. He is the only one, to state the obvious, who is not wearing a mask, even though that is the policy of the Mayo Clinic, which says it shared that policy with the vice president's office, and that when asked why he didn't wear one, well, here's what the vice president said.
Since I don't have the coronavirus, I thought it'd be a good opportunity for me to be here, to be able to speak to these researchers, these incredible healthcare personnel, and look them in the eye and say thank you.
All right, here's the thing. It's not about whether he has the virus or not. He's tested regularly. He doesn't have the virus. It's also not about looking a healthcare professional in the eye, because obviously you still can if you're wearing a mask. It's not a burqa. It's about setting an example. Instead of ignoring the rules that officials are asking people to follow. Out front now, Dana Bash, chief political correspondent, and Dr. Jonathan Reiner, a CNN medical analyst who also advised the White House medical team under President George W. Bush. So, Dr. Reiner, let me start with you. You know, as a doctor here, and also given the role that you had advising the White House, what's your reaction to the vice president of the United States being the only one to ignore the formal policy of the Mayo Clinic, which had been conveyed to his office, and not wearing a mask?
Wow, so wrong. So tone deaf. Look, first of all, on one level, this is just another in a series of mixed messages that we've gotten from this White House about this crisis. You know, on the one hand, you know, we tell the public that we want you to wear a mask when you go out in public, and now the vice president, you know, shows up out of all places, a hospital, and refuses to wear a mask. We saw today that JetBlue is now going to require all passengers to wear a mask. But yet the vice president of the United States, again, goes to a hospital and doesn't wear a mask. I was in late last night for an emergency procedure, and then again early this morning. And every second in the hospital, I wore a mask. Most of the time when I wasn't even in the presence of a patient. And I wore the mask, and we wear the mask every time we're in the hospital, all the time we're in the hospital, to protect our colleagues. So when we tell a patient, when we tell the community to wear a mask, we're telling them to protect their neighbors, that, you know, the old lady that lives next door, the man down the street. You wear a mask to protect the community. We want that message to be perpetuated by the president and the vice president, yet they refuse to do so. They refuse to set an example. I think it's disgraceful.
Dana, you know, to the point that Dr. Reiner is making, the vice president didn't wear the mask today. President Trump, of course, has said he's not going to wear one. His messaging has been confusing, to say the least. Here he is.
Well, I just don't want to wear one myself. Somehow sitting in the Oval Office behind that beautiful resolute desk, the great resolute desk, I think wearing a face mask as I greet presidents, prime ministers, dictators, kings, queens. I don't know. Somehow, I don't see it for myself.
I mean, it's almost like saying, Dana, he's too important to wear one. And then today, by the vice president, whether he realized that, although he certainly should have, was sending the same message. And what does that tell people across the country that they should be doing?
Well, as Dr. Reiner was saying, it's one thing to not wear a mask in the Oval Office or at the White House. You know, a lot of people aren't wearing masks who are you know, tested out and about, who we see at the White House. It's not just the president. But it's a completely different thing when a senior official, one of the most senior officials, particularly the head of the task force, goes to a hospital in order to get out a message about the work that the hospital is doing. And I can tell you there's frustration inside the vice president's office now, because they understand full well that everything that they wanted to do to highlight the work that the Mayo Clinic was doing is getting, you know, swept under the rug or mm-hmm. you know, overshadowed by the fact that he made a mistake and he should have worn a mask because of the guidelines of his own CDC, because of the rules of the Mayo Clinic, and as both of you have said, just common sense when it comes to optics and leadership. I think that despite the vice president defending himself and explaining himself, that the reality of the mistake is setting in as we speak.
And Dr. Reiner, Pence said this to reporters when they asked why he didn't wear a mask. Here's his response.
As Vice President of the United States, I'm tested for the coronavirus on a regular basis. And everyone who is around me is tested for the coronavirus.
And obviously, Dr. Reiner, that's a good thing, but it's really beside the point, isn't it?
It's beside the point. First of all, his test is only valid at the moment he's tested. And he comes into contact with a lot of people. So while he may have been negative when he was tested at whatever point during the week, he wasn't tested as he was walking into the Mayo Clinic. But on the other hand, look, the vice president wouldn't disrespect the synagogue and not wear a skull cap when he walked into it to a temple, or he wouldn't refuse to remove his shoes when he walked into a mosque. You know, hospitals are our new holy places, and he's completely disrespecting the sacrifice that the nurses and the docs and the staff in hospitals make by not wearing a mask. What is he saying to them?
I mean, Dan, I guess that really is the question. And also, it was an opportunity to explain to people about when they should wear a mask, that, right? That when you're outside, if you're out alone or not in a social distance with someone, you don't necessarily need to wear it. But he was obviously very close with people and in a hospital environment. That's the opportunity to show people that's when you wear the mask.
Yeah, I mean, this is obviously a very different situation I'm about to tell you about. But I was with the vice president at the DMZ. Between North and South Korea 3 years ago. And he was incredibly attuned to the optics of what it's going to look like. So given, you know, whether he was behind the glass or outside, all of that. So given that and knowing him and knowing that he understands optics and what that means, imagery, what that means for leadership and how it's perceived, it is surprising that he, no matter what his staff said, no matter what the hospital said, didn't get that intuitively when he looked around and saw everybody else wearing a mask. It was surprising.
Yeah, I mean, just on a human level, everyone else is wearing one and you're not. That's just basic psychology. You feel awkward. You notice you are not like the others. All right. Well, thank you both very much.